Hello world! WayofTime here, bringing to you another episode of EEPower. So I went on a very huge mining expedition and managed to drain my pants, if that makes any sense whatsoever. Found a nice little steel sword and whatnot, and it's very, very, very helpful. So let's look at our resource chest. Wow. I've managed to find 19 diamond ore and probably more redstone than I'll ever use. This will equate to 10 stacks of redstone. So I think we're well off enough for that. So we're going to need to macerate our diamond ore, but I'm thinking another macerator might be required since we are running out of, well, general room for our macerations. We have a lot more that we need to do before we actually get anything really, working, full operational order, small stuff like that. So what I'm thinking this episode will do is attempt to make a rock crusher and use that for most of our maceration. It will be a lot more efficient time-wise, so we don't have to wait around for a while. And we have a lot of extra room. And we have a lot of buildcraft energy. We can expand our buildcraft energy very easily, and it'll be a lot, well, I'll find it. It will be a lot better. So let's go over and macerate our nice little diamonds. We'll have to wait for this to end a bit, and then we can get our diamonds working. We'll need to put more bricks in here, because we're going to also want to make some sort of system that will handle all of that. And also, we'll want to find a way to get our nice little item system working underground with all of this powered as well. So that shouldn't take too much effort. Well, we need to get the items to be pulled out at a quick pace, that's for sure. So we'll need a bit of, well, work to be able to do that. So let's see. Where's our iron? Here it is. So let's look at our nice little rock crusher recipe. If I can actually spell it correctly. Our rock crusher will require steel, diamonds, and piston. The steel is going to take a bit of effort because we need much more coal coke than we currently have in reserves. This goes in here, I do believe. So we will need to find out how to get that at working order. We have 2 blocks of steel already, so we need 18 more steel, but we also need to refine the iron that we have currently. So I'm thinking temporarily stopping this. And we need, what, 10 refined iron for another macerator? Yes, we do. So let's put that there. We'll get the refined iron. We got even more diamonds already. And that should be in good order. Now, we have enough rubber to do everything we need. So that's a plus, at least. So let's wait for our refined iron. Then we'll be good to go. Okay, we got our 9 refined iron. So let's bring everything over to our crafting table over here, so we can pull out our other ingredients at need. So we're going to also need 3 pieces of flint and cobblestone. We got the cobblestone. Do we have any flint? Yes, we do. So over here, we're going to need to make the wires. First of all, I'm thinking we'll go for 2 sets of wires right off the bat. Here we go. One of the sets will be for the normal circuitry and whatnot. We're going to need another one of these. And finally, we can put them all down with our flint and our cobblestone to make another macerator. I'm thinking for this macerator, we're going to hook it up so that we can... Let's see, maybe we can just hook it up on top like so. Yeah, why not? And what shall we put in here? What are we in most need of currently? We are in most need of iron. So let's get our bunch of iron. That will be very helpful in the future. So iron. We need to iron out the kinks a little. I'm not even going to grace that with a reply way. Nope, not gonna happen. Okay, so 24 diamonds shall be sufficient. We have a lot of bricks to make some more coke ovens, and maybe it can work on a coke oven system. That might work. We have a lot of fuel. That seems like we have a lot of fuel. And this is at full charge, and this is charging already at a fifth of its charge. And we got 122 buckets of fuel. And let's see, coal coke had arrived. So we got 9 coal coke already. So let's put this in and make our 9 pieces of steel. We're going to need 9 more, so we will have to wait for all that coal coke to get ready. But I'm thinking we can find some area to make a coal coke array instead of just this simple area right now. How will we do that? I wonder. We can do a manual array for now. Find some area and just place the coal coke all in there. This place is in most need of the coal coke and the blast furnace, so for now I think I'm gonna just put all of them. We need to actually do some planning for this because there's no point just going willy-nilly, hey, here we go, we got something, woohoo. But maybe move it all over to the area right over here. That didn't go well. Huzzah! We're also going to need to cut this tree down, so that's going to take a bit of effort. Why don't I have any sort of axe, I wonder? It'd be pretty easy to craft, though I guess my hotbar is a little lacking in the space department, so I. kind of like NASA. Oh, zing! Okay, so I'm thinking a simple coal coke array around here would be a sufficient area to work with. And once we have the coal coke array, we can just hook it up so that all the output goes into our non-coal coke. Yes, let's go with that. That is a wonderful name, Way. You are a master wordsmith. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. Did I miscount that one? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Of course, it had to be 12. Cannot be an even number. Okay. So if we move it over so that it's 13, like so, and going out like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, doorway, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we have a nice open room like that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And then just seal the deal by going over here. And we have a nice sized room for our coal coke. That will be simple enough. Okay, so how much iron steel we have? Seems like we have enough coal coke to do that. So let's see. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here's the center. And I'm thinking we'll have all of the coke machines going in like so. So we have them nice and bracketed like that, and we will need to be able to get out eventually. Maybe we can have some sort of maintenance area, but this should be simple. Now it seems like we're going to need a bit more string than what we currently have because we will need to get a few deployers once everything's said and done. So we're going to have to figure out how to do that as well, which I don't think is really too much of a kerfuffle, considering. But 4 of these should be a good amount. So let's get everything set for at least 3, and maybe install them and do a manual amount for now. Okay, let's close this. Close this, and I guess that will be fine for now. Ah, yes, another thing we're going to need is more energy over here, because we are definitely running out of a lot of our bare essentials, such as power. We only have 10,000 EU left, so that is not a good thing whatsoever. So this maceration is going to stall eventually, which is not going to be fun. So what I'm thinking of doing is adding in a solar panel to cover all that. So let's get everything. Let's just wait for the last maceration. We can lose a bit of energy. Oops, I lost all the energy. That's not a good thing. Okay, this energy will be required. So what I'm thinking of doing is just making a simple solar panel. Just not the normal one, but the advanced solar panel. We're gonna need a lot of advanced alloy. So let's see how much advanced alloy we need. Well, the advanced circuits are easy enough, so that's simple. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 advanced alloy. We need 9 refined iron to do that. So that means we're going to need to heat all of this up, so turn them into normal iron, and then we're going to have to feed it. Now, in the meantime, we're going to need to have some form of fuel to get this running. Don't really have any form of fuel other than coal, and I want to keep this coal. And as you saw, I found one piece of iridium. It was very hard to find, let's just say. Found it quite accidentally, actually, because a creeper blew up a hole, and then it was there. Thought it was silver, and saw that it took too long to mine it with a diamond drill, so I had to use the rock cutter, which took like 10 seconds, which was not much of a fun at all. Anyways, yes, heating this up, yes, how to do so, yes, guess we can make some more charcoal and get that heated up so that we can at least have a nice little repository, because in the meantime we won't have anything at all to warm everything up. So let's put all of this in. Hopefully we get at least a bit of charcoal before we actually just pretty much ruin ourselves, and it won't be very fun at all. Nom nom nom. So many things up at the same time. Let's see. So we need to get, first of all, we need a normal solar panel, which is going to require silicon cells, which is a bit more difficult than I thought. So soldalite, whatever the case is, we need to get some silicon cells. So we need the industrial centrifuge. Can either use sand or, anyways, an industrial centrifuge is something I'm not too familiar with. So an industrial centrifuge, let's see. Here we go. Oh, phooey. It's gonna require an extractor and some advanced circuitry, which is going to take a lot of effort. So what I'm thinking of doing is, instead of making the solar panels right now, I'll make them later. But I'm going to need to actually work on those machines because they are very derelict right now. Okay, so let's see. We are going to need to get our peat up and running again. So where's our water cells? Water, 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 water. Water? Water! Yay. Okay, so we got that. We got our dirt. Do we have any of our sand left? You know where the sand is? Voided. That's a bit of a pickle. So we'll just have to steal some of the sand from these and get the recyclers up and running later. For now, I don't think it's too much of an issue. It's pretty much a non-issue right now. So we're going to need to get our peat machines up and running again. So this time I'll actually put it in the right order. Put it in the right order and I fail miserably. Way to go, way to go. So, tin, bog earth, we got plenty of bog earth to at least get this up and running again. Like so, and we have enough peat, and that's for sure. So, bog earth in here. And we'll have this running at, let's see, 16 for now. And the other 16 will go into here, but we're going to need some humus. So that's another thing, but will require a lot more dirt than what we currently have. So we have to get dirt, more dirt. Do we have dirt? We have a stack of dirt. Stack of dirt is probably all we're going to need for now. Where is my fertilizer? 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 Hello, fertilizer. Where are you? Are you in my inventory? No, that would be stupid, but probably something I would be likely to do. Okay, obviously it was not in my inventory. It was in somewhere else where it shouldn't have been, but not in my inventory, so I think I'm good. Anyways, so we'll start with 64 hummus and then get these running. We'll do some more manual manipulation later, but I'm thinking we will be good to go later on. When we get everything else going, we can probably get some sort of automated system instead of the stupid way we have it done right now. And that is looking a lot better. Thank you very much. I'll be here all week. So, what was I doing? Yes, that's probably what I was doing. Ah, what I can do in the meantime, though, is have this seed machine running off of both. Huh. Maybe, no, maybe, yes, no, maybe so, I don't know. Okay. Do we have any of these left? Now we got too much energy, that's for sure. Ah, whatever. So, what was I doing? Yes, let's go over there. Okay, here we go. And 7 charcoal, that's not enough, I can attest to that. We're gonna need to run some more and have some better system than this. So, that will put in there, and we have 9 of that going. And maybe we can run geothermal generators, get some sort of lava production, and it'll be a bit more efficient than what we have right now. Let's see our steel. We have 9 pieces of steel. We have 4 more coal coke, so we can get 4 more pieces for now and have that running later. That was a very odd sound, I must say. I'm not even sure where that came from. Hello? Real life? Why did you make that sound? I have no need of it. You are just ruining my day. I hate you for it. Okay, let's get away from the very oddness that I'm spouting right now and try to do something a little more in seriousness. Okay, is that all the sand I have? Yes, it is. So, the coal coke machines we'll make some more of. So, coke, oven, bricks. So, 1, 2, and I guess 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll make a lot of these. And obviously, we do not have enough for that, so we're going to need to, let's see, 26 we need, right? We'll need more sand later. Okay, we got one more coke oven, and we can place this all down and feed it with some coal. And then we'll at least get that process up and running, even though it won't be fully automated. Now, I think everything is run so that the stuff comes at. I'm gonna recess it by 1, because it might be better in the future. Ah, as if. Looks like I'm gonna have to power up my drill soon. Might be a bit more useful than how I'm using it right now, you know? Whacka 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 whacka. And not the Pac-Man type. Okay, let's get this. Come on. Thank you. A lot faster to build like this. And that is sucky. Why did you have to do that? Why? You should feel ashamed of yourself. Feel the shame. Shame. Okay. Now that he has felt the shame, the righteous fury that is Wei, we can keep that going and get some more coal coke from that. And the creosote oil, which we still haven't used much of. Guessing we're gonna need a few more rail systems than we currently have because, well, we need to get all that run. Okay, I think I have all of my lag issues rectified. Basically, I have like a 2 terabyte hard drive, and with all the recording I've been doing lately, I've somehow managed to fill all of it. So, I had to delete a lot of raw footage from a lot earlier episodes. So now I should be in a much higher capacity than I was before. So let's get these going at a faster pace now. This we should be able to get macerating again. And how much energy do we have in total? That's good. Okay. So let's see what we can do over here. We're going to need a lot more string, so what I'm probably going to need to do is eventually go back to the overworld and find a mine shaft and just harvest all the string from one of those. I'll take a bit of time, sure, but really considering all the other stuff that I need to do with all of the, well, string, it's certainly feasible. Okay, so another thing that I think we're going to want to do is get this set up a bit better. Okay, so we're going to need to get some of those deployers to get some item loaders and unloaders. That'll take a bit of effort. Let's see if this fixes those things fast. Are you working? Okay, so we'll get the item loaders and unloaders working, maybe actually spread out the peat evenly, and then we can get the rest of the work stuff going. Okay, now that we have most of our stuff pretty well automated, this stuff's automated completely, but this forester, let's just call it a forester, tree farm definitely works. This tree farm is not exactly working at, well, its best capacity in the sense that, well, this outputs stuff and it doesn't output it very well. In the sense that, well, saplings has to go out and we have to make sure that enough saplings stay in here without getting it overcrowded. So what I'm thinking of doing is having something pretty simple. So let's get rid of this chest for now. Stuff will spill everywhere, but that's okay. And I'm thinking, which is always a bad sign, that we'll need a few more different pipes. We'll need our iron pipe, that will help. Let's throw away some of our useless junk that we don't need currently. I think that's good. And we have our chest, which we'll also use as kind of like a buffer thing where we can put everything else. Okay, so this stuff, it needs birch saplings. To make sure it keeps its birch saplings all together, we can do this. And have this go up and have a golden. No, maybe yes, no, maybe so. Golden pipe go up there, but we can have the items flow from here. They'll come out and everything, such like that. And both of them can use it. Now, this thing, obviously, has to use it in a different manner. For instance, all the saplings have to go out like so. So we're going to have to make sure we have all the saplings going out as well. Now, that's all well and good, but we need everything to pretty much go at a quick pace as well. So what we're probably going to need is two golden pipes or something. Whoa, that was entertaining. Let's stop that because we're probably going to just kill ourselves with enthusiasm. Yay, you are dying due to your own enthusiasm. That is not exactly what we want to do. So, probably are going to need another golden pipe, though that we can rectify eventually. Let's see. The other stuff that comes out of here, we don't really need to worry about being super fast or anything like that. All we need to do is just have this hooked up. And let's put that up. Ah, stop making me lag. Gonna have to face it like that, and this faced up. And all of our saplings will want to go down the black line, like so, and all the remaining stuff will just go out the other line. Now, the main reason we're going to be doing all of that is because the diamond pipe works very interestingly. Let's just put this down so that we can get that working and we can show it. The diamond pipe, as you know, sorts an inventory. It sorts it very easily. It just goes, okay, you're going this way, and oh, you need to go this way. And nothing else needs to be worried about in that case. However, it's very particular in attempting to put items. With how the new build craft mechanics go, what it is that, for instance, in this case, if there are too many saplings, if no more saplings can go in there, it'll continue and basically say any direction is valid. So, for instance, it says birch saplings can only go through the black, but if there's no room for birch saplings afterwards, it just says, okay, I don't care where you want to put it. I'm just going to put it through the other available points. So it knows that it went through green, so okay, I'm going back blue. And then it'll put the remaining saplings into this chest. So now what we're going to need is something a little more, I don't know, something that actually looks good in comparison. What we can do is that we know that nothing can come out of here, so we can just put all of that and attach it so that all of the sand and the logs go through this by default, and the other stuff just detours easily. So to do that a little, no, we can just keep it like that because this is the only way to have it compact. Now we will eventually need some unloaders to get all of the peat and loaders, because frankly we need to get this peat and all of this dirt in other locations than where it currently is. We can set up a simple rail system to handle all of that. That, as I said, will be simple enough to do. We just have to make sure that there's a nice little path to go down. Now, I'm probably going to want to pretty this up with some nice little stuff around this so that we have some nice defined areas because, frankly, it's kind of just ghetto. Let's just say that. It is ghetto, and therefore, we need something a little better. Now, over here, I'm happy with this system. We got enough wheat to get by. In fact, we can probably trade all of that wheat for emeralds, because we will have enough for that. So let's unload all of our junk that we do not need. I think our stuff is properly filled right now, and we can. I think those ferni are done, so we can continue smelting all of the stuff that we need. And we might want to finish our coal dust, because that will be something that we need to do. And also, I think our thing. Yes, our thing is done. Yes, that is very descriptive way. Congratulations, you get a prize for being the most observant YouTuber out there. Mwahaha. Beating around the bush, are we, Wei? Okay, so as I was trying to say, as I was rudely interrupted, our steel should be done by now. So we should go out and check our steel. Also, macerate the remaining of our coal, because that would be nice to do. You know, teleporters would be very nice, but I don't exactly have the EU capacity to do so, so I won't worry about that. This is done, this is done. You deserve to have a lot of charcoal, therefore, I will give you a lot of charcoal. It's going to be quite a lot of energy, but I think we can manage. So go there, and you go there. And we have everything that we need to make those. No, we need to get our other stuff. Our other stuff, its name is stupid. Yes, iron. Iron, iron, iron. We need more iron than that. So we are going to need to get the iron. And then we're going to need to connect everything that we have. So we're also going to need to crush some more obsidian, unfortunately. So I guess I'm gonna have to go back to this world. I don't think I actually showed you what this Miscraft linking book goes to. It just goes to a nice little mining area in the overworld that I have set up. Hopefully no creepers are going to come at me right away, but apparently that is not going to happen. Oh gosh, why does lag have to happen right now? Boom. Boom. There we go. So, as that creeper rudely showed, We have a lot of fun stuff over here, and we can just get all of this obsidian here. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't look like I brought any form of light with me, which is very, very smart, I might add. And I guess I'll just get a bunch of this, and we should be good to go. Okay, I think I found the root issue that I'm having with my fraps and lagging thing. It seems to happen as soon as I'm finished one of my fraps sessions or something. How do you explain it like that? Anyways, let's get this and output it to this side so that you can receive it on this side. Ooh, that's nice and colorful. And then we can get that nice and going, and we can get some pulverized lead. We're going to need some electrum ingots so we can make some more conduits so we can actually put our rock crusher to the test, so to speak. And our steel is nice and finished. So I'm thinking for a temporary rock crusher area, we should want it to go over here next to the wall. We can get it automated later on, but for now, this seems like it's at a good capacity. So, two electrum ingots, or let's get four electrum ingots. Wrong chest. Oops. One, two, three, four. And all the silver is going to need to get processed at a later date, so we can get that done. We are going to need to get a bit more string than what we have currently, but that's not too much of a thing to worry about. So, 16 energy conduits will transpose the liquid into here, get those all worked up and whatnot, and we are definitely getting enough energy, and in fact we are getting such a surplus of energy that we need to use all of this. So where are we going to put it? We're pretty much going to put it right here for the time being, though we can edit that location at a later date when we choose to. So let's see, we are going to need 12 pistons, so we're going to need a bit more than that, 12. There we go. Oops, we are going to need more than that. Okay, so this is going to need more of our iron stuff, isn't it? Yes, let's get that. Iron, iron, we got iron. Yay, yay, yay. Whoop-de-doo, and I'm going crazy. Hey, I just met you, and this is crazy. Why are you talking about this? Don't call me, ever. Okay, after I lapsed into idiocy for the umpteenth time, let's go for a nice even 12. We're going to have to go... we don't have enough cobblestone. That is just great. That is perfect way. Perfect. Of all of the stupid things we have to lack, it is cobblestone. Sigh. Some people. The nerve of some people. It's just wrong. Totally wrong that we have to just run around being a complete idiot. Hey, what's that? I'm like that already? Okay, carry on. I have fun. Okay, so 12. Let's actually see if we can get this in some reasonable capacity this time. 12. There we go. So we got that. So 12 pistons. We're going to need to go like this. And we're actually going to need 16. No, we only needed 12. That's just terrific. Okay. I don't know how many we needed, okay? I'll just check. Oh, gosh. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's actually get this block done at least, and then we can check. We need 12. We get 4 per, so we only needed 3 blocks of steel. And we have that in the wrong location anyway, so let's do that and that. And we got our required amount of rock crushers, and we have some pistons with which we can use later. So rock crusher bricks over here. We'll place them in a simple format like so, and we got a rock crusher. Now we're going to need to input some energy, which should be simple enough to do. I think let's go with the energy line that we have here. That'll be nice and standard, at least. Am I actually getting it on the right side? No, I'm not. Okay, so over here, as I proceed to ruin the ground for all eternity. Man, Greenpeace really hates me right now, I bet. Okay, There we go. And conduits. Do we have enough? Okay. Take that back. Put that down. And we definitely have enough. So let's power this thing up. And we're pretty much good to go. No. Protect me. So. We're going to need some output into this in terms of megajoules. And actually get this connected, which would be a plus. So, already fully operational, and we are destroying the landscape one block at a time. I like your style. So, all that we're going to need to do is take the items out of this, and we're going to need a feed into it. So, this can pretty much be our ore processing thing. So, just a simple thing like that. So, we're going to need an engine, which will be simple to make. Did I say it was simple? Yes, I did. I think because it is. Oh my gosh. How could you? So we're going to need a bit more. We got the iron. We're just going to need to get a bit more of our wood that we do not seem to have in any capacity whatsoever. But oh well. Over here, might as well just fill the saplings up because why not? Fill, yes, yay, woo, this is enough wood, I think. I might be wrong, but it might be correct. Okay, so, let's get this show on the road. So, two gears. And do we have any glass whatsoever? No, we do not, so we're going to need to run for that as well. So, we need glass. And I think tin will be another thing we'll need eventually, though I think we might need to worry about that particular project segment at a later time. Let's see, what was I looking for? Glass? Glass? Glass! Glass? Glass? There is no glass. There is no glass. Okay, so we're going to need to make some more glass, and I need to actually get this in a steady supply eventually. I have no idea why I don't have a chest full of glass, seeing as we're gonna have a lot of glass from the quarry as soon as we get it in a much higher operational capacity than it currently is going at. So glass over here. We're also going to need to just get a bunch of ores to dump into the machine because we need it to process as much as we can. So I'm thinking redstone and lapis will be a good candidate at least. And we can bring some gold because that will be good. I don't think we need anything else in any major supply currently. So, ouch, we can go with that. Glass. Okay, time stop. Let's get that working. Okay, so we got our piston, we got our wood. We got our glass, and we got our gears. Therefore, we have an engine. And let's actually get this in some capacity. Let's start it going. So it should go at a fast pace. I think there should be some way to disable that eventually. Hey, no, you are pointing at the wrong location. So, that way, we're going to need a lever. So many levers were not made that day. Down! There we go. Four levers, that should be a sufficient quantity. Hey, go there! Okay. So actually make this. We're gonna need another thing, I'm sure. Chest. So here we got a chest. We'll put it down. And it'll grab at least some of the stuff that we have in here. Now, it does seem like it's going to be a little slow. I think we're going to need another piston as well. And this ore processor is going to need to go deep underground. I can tell you that. Because currently... Hey, I heard something go. Currently, right now, it's going to just be rather annoying to have that running constantly while going... And I'm sure that listening to that 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, will not be the most fun thing ever. So, let's just throw some of that in and actually change the order of this so that we actually get some useful stuff to come out right away. I'm thinking that once we get some sort of redstone gate system going, we can get things going at a bit better of a pace than we are going right now. But we'll see how that goes. So I'm thinking the easiest way to get that. How far can we go? I wonder. Okay, I can hear it at about 16 blocks, so we're going to need to put it very deep underground if we're going to have anything. We're going to have some loss, I'm sure. But considering the head trauma that we'd have with all those sounds going off at once, I think it will be a preferred alternative. We can go with that. Dirt, 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 dirty, dirty, dirt. Well, that's all the time we have for this episode of EE Power. If you like what you see, don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe to future episodes. Hopefully, I'll manage to rectify the issue with fraps. I'm not sure. Maybe I'll have to defragment my hard drive so that it'll work in a much better capacity, but I'm hoping that we'll be able to get that working much better so that we can save our eyes from utter destruction. WayofTime here, signing off. Have a wonderful day.